All right, we're gonna cover a stutter step series. So we've talked about in and outs, we talked about pull-ups, we talked about, you know, in and out cross and all these different moves, ball handling. And the other day we talked about dribbling and using our footwork, whether it was we dribble and we step, and we went dribble and step at the same time regardless. But all that to say is footwork is so important to not just your ball handling, but to also sell and fake one way and go the opposite way. The third reason it's important, and you'll see in these moves, it allows you time to read your defender before you make a decision. So again, this is a stutter step series. The first thing we're gonna do, before I show you even the drills, we're just gonna break down the footwork, the timing, and all the keys that go into it. So if I have the ball and I'm coming down, and maybe I'm going down game speed, and I got a defender who's in front of me, so this is a scenario when you're attacking, and there's a defender in front of you with space. So you're attacking to him, and you start here, and you attack. Another thing you can do is this. You come in here and go hard, stutter, change directions. You could also get in here and I'm attacking this event, I got one way to go, I stutter, in and out. What it does is it allows you the time to kind of read your defender, and it also gets them off balance with just short, choppy steps. So step one, you want a good short and choppy steps. A good way to think of it is this. Say you're like, you got a ladder, you're doing like ladder drills, so you're like, 2 feet in, 2 feet out, 2 feet in, 2 feet out. Or just whatever helps you chop your feet. It's just, you're on your toes, you're on your toes. All you need is a couple, and then you can make a reach. So number one, get a good short and choppy steps. Number two, you wanna sell your inside shoulder. So say I got the ball here, and all I'm gonna do is use my feet, not even a move. I would chop my feet, sell my shoulder, and then I go that way. Really sell your shoulder. Number three, and we're gonna break this down in a sec, is make a read, okay? So stutter steps, roll and sell your shoulder, then make a read based on wherever your defender is leaning, okay? So before we even get to these moves, I'd encourage you to go ball on your right and literally just work on like half speed, just kind of get the feeling. Just kind of messing around with kind of stuttering your feet. Then I'd mess around with ball on your left, just take a dribble and stutter, dribble, stutter, dribble, and just kind of get the feel of it before we go into the actual moves. So drill one and move one is just gonna be a stutter and go. A stutter and go, okay? Three keys. Number one, when you stutter, you're lighting on your toes, okay? So number one, stutter steps. Number two, throw shoulder. Number three, you want the ball actually back and protected before you go downhill. You see a lot of times defenders, good defenders, when a defender doesn't, they just move their feet and go, the ball is exposed and they can just hit it out. So it's actually really important that if you don't make a live ball move, you have the ball protected before you actually go that way, okay? So move one, stutter and go. What we're gonna do is go stutter and go into finishes, then stutter and go into pull-ups. So I'm right here, I'm coming down, I stutter, I go. I get into a little finish right here. You're gonna make five finishes at the rim. Second part of this move, you're gonna go stutter and go into a pull-up. So I'm here, I stutter, I go, I get into a little pull-up right here. You're gonna make five. The last one you're gonna do is this. You're gonna go stutter and go, one dribble, change directions, pull-up. So now I'm here, I stutter, I go, change directions, get into a nice little gather, and pull up going left. Make five. The second one you're gonna do is this. You're now gonna go stutter, stutter, in and out, go. So the three keys on this is number one, stutter steps. Number two, throw your shoulder. Number three, on the in and out, get the ball tight and close. Make sure it comes across your belly button. So stutter steps, throw shoulder, belly button and out, and then attack. So again, it's gonna be the same series. Stutter, in and out, finish. Stutter, in and out, pull up. Stutter, in and out, one dribble, change directions. So I start like this, I come down. Stutter, in and out, one dribble, pull up. Then I get my rebound. Now I go same deal. Stutter, in and out, one dribble, change. Quick pick up, pull up. I would do that. Five finishes, five pull-ups, five one dribble pull-up, change direction pull-ups. The third and final move is now we come downhill, we dribble. Step one, we stutter. Step three, we throw our shoulder. Or step two, we throw our shoulder. Step three, when we go in and out, we see our defender leaning. So now on the in and out, we cross it back. And then we get into our same series. So now it's this. I'm gonna show you half speed real quick. So I come down, I stutter, in and out, oh, cross, boom, get into a finish. Now I'm gonna show you game speed. So I'm here, I'm coming down, stutter, in and out, cross, I get into a finish right here. I make five. Now I come here, I dribble down, stutter, in and out, cross, pull up, I get that one, I make five. Third one is this. I come down, stutter, front dribble, change directions, get into a little pull up right here, and then I make five. So as you get to see, the three moves we're doing is this, stutter, step, and go. Second one, stutter, step, and in and out. Third one, stutter, step, in and out, and cross. After each move, you're gonna go five finishes, make. Then you're gonna make five one dribble pull ups. Then you're gonna make five, one dribble, change direction, pull-ups. After you've done all those on the right side, repeat and do the same exact steps on the left. Remember, stutter steps are great because number one, it allows you to buy time and read your defender. Number two, when an offensive player is coming at you full speed and they're just quickly stepping, a lot of times you're like a little off balance. It's hard to predict what you're gonna do. Number three, it allows you to kinda go from being up into being low super quickly. All right, so as an offensive player, if you can just have this in your game, you're gonna be so much more explosive, and you're ultimately, once you really master it, you're gonna be a lot better at making reads now that you have a split extra second to break down and see where the defense is leaning.